Hello, ladies and gents, everything between and without. Welcome to more Hill World of Warcraft. And today we have Aszhara on heroic mode. This is probably the first dungeon that most people do because most people tend to pick this zone. I forget what it's called as their first. Basically, the zone with the ghost elves and such, you know, and the first introduction of the withered and the blue dragonflight. I completely forget what it's called. Sorry, it's been quite some time since I played Legion, you know. But yeah, take this path, kill as few people as possible, focus on the casters mostly. And soon we will get to Warlock Parzesh. I don't know how it's pronounced. Fuck it. Also, be wary. You may actually, if you do enough AOE, you may attract a turtle to fight you. Go over this small ridge and kill the snakes, I guess. No, Naga. Kill these three Naga. And then you are free to deal with the warlord, whatever. Now it's just you, me, and my guards. Yes, he's quite the leader. Okay, so this guy will throw a javelin at you from time to time. Please try to stand. Try to have someone behind you, because I think it knocks you back. And if you don't have anyone behind you, then I don't know. There's some mechanic. Okay, next, you have to kill two of these Naga casters, which have this freaky particle effect behind them. Well, particle and vapor effect. These, what are they called? Whatever. These Naga witches. Of course, water mount if you have it for this part, or no, water walking, go through here. If you go near enough to her, then she will hurt you. But thankfully, she did not do that now, because we were not close enough to her. That's called a hate coil arcanist. Okay, good. Glad we sorted that out at least. Kill these two, and that will deactivate Lady Hatecoil's protections. Yeah. These guys have some shitty. Oh yeah, and there's some wind which will push you away. As you can see, the stuff did damage to the team. Some people will just aggro these droplets before the boss, just so that you know, AoE will not attract them while we are fighting the boss. Okay. So, Lady Hatecoil has a couple of mechanics here. Actually, only two. First is Statinova. You have to be on land to not get hurt by it. And then you have to go into the water because I think that whenever someone is on land, then thunder will go down and destroy that piece of land, so that at the next static shock there will be less land for you to stand on. That's the idea behind Lady Hatecoil's two mechanics. All right, here most people tend to kill the adds the mobs around the boss before targeting the boss, because as you can see there are quite a lot of them. And someone was asking if I needed a certain item. I think I ignored them or did not see, because I was a serious healer trying to do my damn job and people were just trying to, you know, distract me with loot and such. Fuck that, my job is number one priority. is my number one priority. Alright, so the third boss is King D. No, it's Serpentrix. Yeah, Serpentrix. And his trick is that when you make him reach a certain percentage of health, he will spawn multiple heads. Most people kill the mini heads first, but of course, us being OP because it was the end of the expansion, we actually targeted the main head and managed to kill him. Okay, now, and before I think a wind starts, try to avoid all of these mobs. You can avoid them with the correct pathfinding. And go into this cave. In this cave, you can actually skip this giant quite easily, which I did. Don't AoE because you have snails. You can, or you know, you can kill the giblins if you want. For expediency, I suggest you don't kill those first. You have to kill these ones before, because there is no avoiding them, unfortunately. You can also skip this giant too. Some people will go for the treasure, which spawns somewhere in front of us now. Sometimes it spawns, sometimes it doesn't. This time it didn't. You can also avoid these murlocs for some dumb reason someone pulled. And then holy shit, someone really pulled everything. Sorry. So someone pulled everything. This is a dumb move and I don't know who did it, but whatever. Although, as you can see, at least you get some loot out of it. So it's not all bad. You go over this ridge to avoid the other group of murlocs. And for some reason, someone targeted the seagull. And then you arrive at these two giants. And they do AoE shit, as you can see. They do ground attacks and don't stand in the water spouts or whatever those are. Don't stand in the thunder. The thunder is natural to this area. And next we have King Deepbeard. So this it has a few attacks. I think he like tries to drown you. Yeah, see, you can AoE attacks, then that shit with circles on the ground, avoid them. Yeah, just go down there and you kill about four more Arcanists. And then you kill the Wrath of Aszhara, and there you go. And of course you start at the left. With the Ritualist Leshhauder. Ritualist, okay, sorry, my bad. There's a clear difference between Arcanist and Ritualist. Just go and ask the people at Guild Wars. I think I talked about the original Guild Wars quite a bit in my old videos. That was a game I played the shit out of. It was a fun game. And the fact that they added challenges even after all the expansions were out. Just you know. Just added to the enjoyment. I know that I played a shit ton of hours. It was very cool. Now I have the Wrath of Aszhara. He does a few water attacks. Do not stay into the flooding, you know. And that's kind of it. Cry of Wrath. Be careful of it. And that's it. Enjoy the rest of the LP. It's almost done. Bye.